My name is Ian MacDonald. I am a science fiction writer from Northern Ireland. I live just outside Belfast. I've been writing science fiction since 1988, which is a very long time indeed. It's the only thing I know how to do. And so if the writing ever stops, I don't know what I'd do, but people keep reading my stuff and I'm happy with that. My most recent book in France is La Petite Déesse. Et les autres nouvelles. It's a collection of stories set in India in the year 2047. And it's a companion volume to my novel Le Fleuve de Dieu, which won the Grand Prix Imaginaire. And it's all the stuff that didn't go into the book, went into the stories. So they add to the world of Le Fleuve de Dieu and shine a light into different corners of Indian society, and I like it very much. My most recent novel for adults is La Maison de Dervish, the Dervish House from De Noël. But I also have a secret novel, Everness from Gallimard Jeunesse, for younger readers, and it's a load of fun. It's like a real load of fun. It's good for adults as well as kids, and I'm very, very fond of it. Today, I was very lucky and very honored to receive the Planet Award from the influential SF bloggers of France, and that's kind of a very special award because it's the bloggers who set the opinions. When PR departments in publishing houses send out books, they don't send them to the newspapers anymore because nobody reads newspapers. They send them to the bloggers. So these are the people whose opinions really matter. And if they thought that the Dervish House, La Maison des Derviches, was the best book of the year, then you know, I am very honored by that because they are the people whose opinions really matter. So I'm very happy about that. It's a big thing. As a kid, my mother turned me into a science fiction writer by making me watch a British series called Thunderbirds by a guy called Gerry Anderson. It's about puppets, a puppet series called Thunderbirds. And I loved it. And that was kind of my entry drug. And then I got onto the hard stuff, like kind of written science fiction. And I used to plague and pester and annoy the librarians in our local library to find out what science fiction books they had. And I read my way through the entire science fiction section in the library. And I read Michael Moorcock, and I read Harlan Ellison, and I read Ursula Le Guin, and I read Robert Silverberg, and kind of all the great writers, Robert Heinlein, all the great writers of that. And then along came cyberpunk, and that kind of made me go, oh, this is interesting, because when I was 16 years old, punk music arrived, and punk music was like the greatest thing that ever happened in the history of the universe. There was nothing greater than punk, and I loved the music and I loved the lifestyle, but I wished there'd be something like that for writing. And then a few years later, along came cyberpunk, and it did exactly the same thing as punk music did, and I said, this is exciting, this is kind of what I want to write. So over the years, I kind of fused cyberpunk with the old school science fiction I was reading and kind of made them into my own thing. I mean, I write very much about the developing world, you know, India, Brazil, Turkey, Africa, East Africa, places like that, because I think they're the places where the interesting stuff is happening. You know, it's where all the new ideas are coming from. It's where people are doing their own thing with technology that's completely different to anything that we ever thought about it. So what I'm doing with the book I'm writing at the moment, I'm still writing about a developing society. It just happens to be on the moon, and I'm taking all the ideas from the developing world and putting them on the moon up there, and it's turning into something very exciting indeed. Something that surprises me as I'm writing it. Go and buy La Petite Déesse. It's a collection of stories that tells the future, the kind of future history of India, of my science fictional India. It's seven stories that kind of span a period of about 30 years. I wrote them all independently, but they actually all fit a timeline. And it has some of my best writing in it. And it has some characters that you will remember forever as well. And I like it very much.